Well, hello, everyone, and welcome to another exciting Saturday night family event of Roller Derby. We're excited to see our home team, Demolition City Roller Derby, play for another win. Let's head to the track and see if we can catch some of our favorite girls warming up. Why, look there, it's Patty. Wave hello, Patty, and off she goes, lickety-split. I mean, lickety-splint? Well, who is that catching up with Patty? Why, that's Steffery. Here's Patty. Look at Patty spin. See that Patty skate? Skate, Patty, skate. So graceful. See that Steffery? Why, there she is again. Jump that apex, Steph, jump. Steph, slow down. Patty, look out. Did you see Steph hit Patty? Steph, what a pill. I believe that Patty is hurt. Is there a doctor in the house? Anyone? I sure hope that Patty is okay. That just goes to show you folks, even being playful can result in an injury. Patty probably shouldn't go back in for the rest of the game. The team doctor needs to check her for a concussion.
While we're being a little silly here, let's pause and take a look at just what exactly a concussion is. According to the Centers for Disease Control, or CDC, a concussion is a type of traumatic brain injury, or TBI, caused by a bump, blow, or jolt to the head, or by a hit to the body that causes the head and brain to move rapidly back and forth. This sudden movement can cause the brain to bounce around or twist in the skull, stretching and damaging the brain cells and creating chemical changes in the brain. These chemical changes make the brain more sensitive to any increased stress or injury until it fully recovers. It is often thought that concussions only occur when the head strikes a solid surface. However, there are many ways to acquire a concussion. A direct blow to the head, face, or neck, or elsewhere on the body with an impulsive force transmitted to the head can result in a concussion. Examples of impulsive forces in roller derby include, but are not limited to, a hard fall on the behind. For example, when the skates slide out from under the skater and the skater falls hard on the bum. A rapid deceleration or acceleration, also known as whiplash. For example, when a skater is hit from behind, as in a back block, or from the side, as in a hip check. Another example of an impulsive force is a hit to the mouth, face, neck, or helmet. And finally, the head hitting a solid surface, such as the floor or any other hard obstacle around the track, is an example of an impulsive force. As you can see in this model from the CDC, the forceful whipping motion of the head and neck can cause the brain to bounce about inside the skull. This motion alone can cause a concussion without the head hitting a solid surface. Remember, with a concussion, there is most often no visible injury to the structure of the brain. This means that tests like an MRI or a CT scan typically appear normal. We caution skaters that simply because an MRI or CT scan is normal or clear, this does not mean that the skater does not have trauma to the brain. Symptoms of a concussion may not appear immediately and may develop over a course of hours to days to weeks. Therefore, caution should be taken, specifically in regards to return to play.
Gosh, Bangs, I heard you took a hard hit out there.
Yeah, Coach, but I didn't even hit my head. The doc said I had to stop playing because of a concussion, but I didn't hit my head.
Bangs, you can get a concussion a lot of ways. Anytime there's a whipping motion to your head, like when you get hit hard, or when you fall hard on your butt, or if you take a helmet to the face, like what happened here today, you could have a concussion.
Well, I saw stars, but I didn't black out. I kind of had a headache, but why did those refs call me out? They suck.
You see this? These are just some of the symptoms you can have with a concussion. And symptoms can take days, even weeks to show up. But even I see these symptoms in you right now, and so did the team doctor. Look, Bangs, the bottom line is there were indications of a concussion during the scat performed on the sidelines. I cannot in good conscience let you continue to play. And even if I could, I would not. Besides, wouldn't you rather be safe than sorry? There is life after Derby.
Symptoms of a concussion include, but are not limited to, slow to respond, a loss of consciousness. This may or may not occur. It may last only for a few seconds. Confusion. A skater can't recall an event before or after a hit. Disorientation. Dizziness or balance problems. Vomiting. The skater answers questions slowly. Slurred speech. A headache. The skater has memory issues. Restlessness. Irritability. Loss of coordination. There is a change in personality. Fatigue. The inability to sleep. The inability to focus. Sensitivity to light or loud sounds. All teams should have annual baseline concussion screenings using the Sport Concussion Assessment Tool, or SCAT. Preseason baseline testing with the most current SCAT can be helpful for interpreting post-injury test scores. Per the SCAT, any athlete with a suspected concussion should be removed from play immediately. The skater should be assessed by a medical professional trained in giving and interpreting the SCAT. The skater should be monitored for deterioration, and the skater should not drive a motor vehicle until cleared by a medical professional. We know concussions can take anywhere from hours to days to weeks to appear. It is important, if a skater thinks they have acquired a concussion, that they sit out of the game or practice. Skaters must see a medical professional trained in understanding concussions. And finally, the teammates and skater's family members need to watch the skater for further symptoms of a concussion.
Bangs, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling really well. I don't have a headache anymore.
That's fantastic. All of your symptoms are gone, your SCAT has returned to baseline, so now we can start the return to play criteria.
Wait, all my symptoms are gone, but I can't go back skating?
Oh, no, no, no. I will monitor you through the return to play criteria. There are specific guidelines that we need to follow.
Okay.
The WFTDA safety protocol includes a graduated return to play process following a concussion. It is strongly recommended that each team have established a relationship with a team physician who is knowledgeable of concussions and other sports injuries. This physician can aid in the return to play guidelines and evaluations of the skater with a concussion. Anyone with a concussion should not be told, "It's just a concussion," or "It's just a mild concussion." Concussions are serious business and can have a tremendous, lasting impact on the brain. To coaches and teammates, if a skater may have a concussion, the best thing to do is, when in doubt, sit them out. And remember, there is life after Derby.